can discipline desire, whether one can curb it, is a deeper question altogether, which is, what do you desire? What makes you itch? What sort of a situation would you like? Let's suppose, I do this often in vocational guidance of students. They come to me and say, well, we're getting out of college and we haven't the faintest idea what we want to do. So I always ask the question, what would you like to do if money were no object? How would you really enjoy spending your life? Well, it's so amazing. As a result of our kind of educational system, crowds of students say, well, we'd like to be painters, we'd like to be poets, we'd like to be writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. Or another person says, well, I'd like to live an out-of-doors life and ride horses. I say, do you want to teach in a riding school? Let's go through with it. What do you want to do? When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that. And forget the money. Because if you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is, to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid. Better to have a short life, that is, full of what you like doing, than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is, you can eventually turn it, you can eventually become a master of it. The only way to become a master of something is to be really with it. And then you'll be able to get a good fee for whatever it is. So don't worry too much. Somebody's interested in everything. And anything you can be interested in, you'll find others who are. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like in order to go on spending things you don't like and doing things you don't like and to teach your children to follow in the same track. See, what we're doing is we're bringing up children and educating them to live the same sort of lives we live, in order that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children, to bring up their children to do the same thing, so it's all wretch and no vomit. It never gets there. And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question. What do I desire? And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question. What do I desire?
Live the fast life, go! Well, I forgot. Live the fast life, go! Beat my goal! Live the fast life, go! I got a big walk by. Beat my goal!
And so, therefore, it's so important to consider this question. What do I desire? so, therefore, it's so important to do this question.
The beat kicks, then I start rocking.
What do I desire? Do I desire? Do I desire? What do I desire? What do I desire? Life spent in a miserable way.
Everybody get on the floor, do your thing. Whatever it is, ooh, ah, Lord. Hey.
Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way.
Whatever it is.
in fancy hats and pretty girls with pretty smiles, all decked out in the latest styles. Rough taking, hip shaking, cuties now. Talking about some fascinating, devastating beauties now. All the soul brothers, jitterbuggers, hip cats in fancy hats and pretty girls with pretty smiles, all decked out in the latest styles. Rough taking, hip shaking, cuties now. Talking about some fascinating, devastating. Devastating beauties now.
touch my soul
sometimes.
Like, you know, and the government's definitely involved in, like, people have died because of the corruption in government, right? Yeah. Everybody agrees.
I mean, there's
that,
so much
right?
proof, like, yeah. that, you know, Bay of Pigs.
Everything. There's so much proof. Yeah. Operation Northwoods, even like, people that, like, always defend the government, they will acknowledge that Operation Northwoods was real, where they were planning on. So when you look at the government, if you narrow down the government to one person, it would be like, would you agree? It'd be like, the government's kind of like Arturo Gatti, John Gatti, right? Like a gangster.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Right.
Yeah,
right. So for me, it's very similar, right? So if you just, I'm trying to simplify it.
Mm-hmm.
If you just look at, like, I don't trust anything coming from John Gatti. He's murdered motherfuckers. He's a shady gangster. That's how I perceive government. So anytime I get information from the government, a government agency, whether it's NASA or whatever. You know, NASA faked 6 moon missions, man. I mean, how are you going to believe anything from that?
Dude, I met Buzz Aldrin.
How are you going to believe anything from that?
I met Buzz Aldrin, and he seemed, no joke, he seemed like he hadn't fucking been to the moon, man.
Of course he hasn't.
You know, because I'm trying to, like, engage him, and this look in his eyes seemed so, like,
yeah,
like he was trying to just play a little bit of a part.
So I don't believe anything coming from him.
Yeah, I've never trusted the government,
dude. I don't believe anything. You know, then they say, well, what about space? I go, all our space information since 1958, that's when NASA was formed in 1958, all our information, and it was formed by Nazis. Wernher von Braun, the director of all 6 fake moon missions, was one of Hitler's right-hand men. He was a fucking rocket scientist for Hitler, who was evil as fuck. He directed 6 moon missions, masters of propaganda, directed 6 moon missions.
Right, he'd be the perfect guy. He'd be the perfect guy to do that.
And when he died, he was like, he was on some deathbed confessional type shit. He told his assistant, he said, on his deathbed, according to her, he said, the fake alien invasion is coming. Like, the fake alien invasion is what they've been planning. That's what's going to scare everybody into a one world government. It's always been about a one world government, and the fake alien invasion, that'll get everybody together. Everybody will volunteer. We gotta, you know, the aliens are gonna kill us. We gotta all unite.
Yep.
So that's been the plan, the fake, and that's what Wernher von Braun said, and on his tombstone.
The strategy that Wernher von Braun taught me was that first the Russians are going to be considered to be the enemy. In fact, when I met him in 1974, they were the enemy, the identified enemy. We were told that they had killer satellites. We were told that they were coming to get us and control us, the dirty commies, that whole story. First, the Russians were the enemy against whom we're going to build space-based weapons. Then terrorists would be identified, and that was soon to follow. We heard a lot about terrorism. Then we were going to identify third world country crazies. We now call them nations of concern. But he said that would be the third enemy against whom we would be needing to build space-based weapons.
In what way are you different?
I am trying to do with my life something which few people try to do. And this influences my thinking and consequently my actions.
What is it you're trying to do with your life?
I tell the truth.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble. When you worry, you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Everybody down, so don't worry, be happy, don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy, don't worry, be happy. worry, be happy. Don't worry, don't worry, don't do it. Be happy. Put a smile on your face. Don't bring everybody down like this. Don't worry. It will soon pass, whatever it is. Don't worry, be happy.